that conversation we need to have totally as well, but we are just getting warmed up.
We are just getting warmed up. The New York Stock Exchange has never looked more beautiful than it does right now, and it will for the next 24 days as this tree is lit. I want to introduce a really dear friend of ours, someone that we work with every day, Stacey Cunningham, the 67th president of the New York Stock Exchange. She started in this role in 2018, but she's been a fixture in this building since 1996, arriving here as an intern from Lehigh University, has been with us all the way through and led us through this most extraordinary
year and a half, from when the stock market closed, and all the volatility went.
But we still lit that tree last year. So this is our 98th annual tree lighting. This is the oldest tree lighting in the country. We beat the White House by 2 weeks. So I feel pretty good about that. So we've taken the claim, it's been since 1923, and we were celebrating here the electrical grid that really changed Lower Manhattan and on. So welcome to the Lower Manhattan community. We're glad to have you back here this year in person. We thank a lot of people, but I want to thank all of those that kept us safe. Front lines and the doctors and the pharmaceutical companies that came up with vaccines and get us back out here. So thank you to all of you. And we thank some of the special team on the NYC, the members of the NYC team who have really moved mountains to keep things moving here. So thank you. But thank you to the broader NYC team. It's been a great year. And whether you are here in this building or remote on Zoom or WebEx or whatever system you're using, it's been great to see you and it's great to see you in person. So this year's tree lighting is all about giving back. And we tapped into our NYC listed company community to highlight some of the ways that they give back. So they donated ornaments, and you can see so many of the members of our community are supporting causes that matter to them. And the charities that they support are highlighting our ornaments spread around today. Many times when companies raise money. So they go out and change the world and change the way we live, work, and play every single day. But a big part of what they do is give back to their communities. I also want to talk, though, about an organization that's going to bring us to the tree lighting, and I know you're anxious. The Robinson Foundation has always been about giving back. And I'm going to welcome a gentleman out here who knows a lot about giving back, and he's going to be our official tree lighter this year. Since 1988, over the past 33 years, Robinhood has raised $3 billion to support fighting poverty in New York, to create opportunities for people who may not have otherwise had them, and to literally change the way people are living in this city. So I am so honored to be able to introduce the head, the CEO of Robinhood Foundation. Rick Fury just took over at Robinhood in September. He is a native New Yorker, born in East New York, went to Stuyvesant High School, went on to Harvard, and he's now leading an organization that's going to touch all of our lives here in New York. And it is my great honor to welcome Rich Fury up here as this year's tree lighter.
Robinson Foundation, as you just heard, for 33 years, have been on the front line of supporting New Yorkers in need. Over the last 2 years alone, we've invested over $340 million in hundreds of organizations who are on the front lines helping provide people with housing, food, education, job training, all the things that we need to live lives of opportunity and dignity. We all know that the last year and a half been hard on everyone. We have all struggled. Let's all remember that we are here together celebrating that some of us have struggled more than others, and that for the vulnerable in New York, it has been a particularly damaging year. Let me get out. New Yorkers have faced difficult choices that have cost New York and seen their income decline over the years. Children are not able to live and buy food.
I said, I love how you're doing this. It's so stupid.
I'm gonna have to because I knew this was fake. But I thought they were just going to like it too.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.